There's many ways to think about robotics. One way to think about it is think about what kind of applications are we building? Is it robots that manipulate objects versus flying robots versus walking robots and so forth? To enable robots to do drastically new things compared to what they've done in the past, machine learning is going to play a key role. And we study how can we use existing machine learning to enable robots to do things that they could never do before. But that could be across any of the domains. It could be manipulation, it could be locomotion, it could be flying, it could be driving. But the underlying technology, the underlying new ideas are really about how to build more intelligent systems that act in the real world, in the physical world. When we think about how to equip robots with new skills, and we want to go beyond traditional programming, we want a robot to learn something, acquire a skill more naturally, there's really two main ways to do it. One is imitation learning. It's where a robot learns from human demonstrations. And the second one is reinforcement learning, where the robot learns from its own trial and error. And the demo that we saw is Brett, Berkeley Robot for Elimination of Tedious Tasks, doing reinforcement learning. It is trying to put a block into a matching opening. It initially doesn't know what that even means. It has no idea. When we say that, we have a lot of ideas of what that means, but Brett doesn't know. All Brett knows is essentially it's going to be scored a bit like a dog gets trained. When you say good dog, bad dog, that's essentially what's happening underneath in reinforcement learning. Brett just waves its arm, something happens, and you say, pretty bad. Waves it in a different way, say, a little better. And over time, from that feedback, it starts fine-tuning its skill and getting that block into the matching opening. It used to be that you really needed very specific domain expertise to get things working. I would say what's a little different about what we're doing in my lab is that we're really coming from the machine learning point of view.